fans are an important part of any computer build because while components like CPUs and graphics cards have their own coolers attached to them, some of that waste heat is going to remain inside your case, so you need fans to blow it all out. Not only that, but fans have become a key aesthetic component in recent years as well, with different kinds of RGB fans providing visual pop and tying together your PC's entire look. But with multi-fan configurations being more popular than ever, it's good practice to have a way to control all of your fans. Now, it is possible to just connect your fans with adapters directly to your power supply, in which case the fans will just stay on at full speed all the time. But this isn't a great idea because running your fans that fast will usually be pretty loud. So while the inside of your PC case can get quite warm if you're gaming or performing some other demanding task like rendering a video, you typically don't need your fans running at full speed to clear out the hot air. And that doesn't even cover the fact that you will lose customization options for any RGB lighting that you might have. So, a more common option is to plug the fans directly into the motherboard, which does allow for control of fan speeds, as well as lighting, but it can be very messy and inconvenient to try and snake all of those fan cables around to different parts of your motherboard. Not to mention that you could easily find yourself running out of fan headers, especially these days where having a half a dozen or even more fans in your system isn't all that uncommon. So check out the iCUE Commander Core XT from Corsair. Not only does it provide enough headers for 6 RGB case fans, but it includes 2 temperature sensors that you can reposition anywhere you'd like inside your case, as well as support for up to 264 RGB LEDs right out of the box. It's also compatible with other Corsair iCUE devices, such as lighting expansion kits and all-in-one coolers, so you can combine them together with your Commander Core XT for a totally seamless experience. So all this means that a separate fan controller is typically the best option if you want both customization and convenience. Now, it used to be that fan controllers would mount on the front of your case in an optical drive bay with little knobs on them that allow you to control your fans, but modern ones usually sit behind the motherboard tray and are controlled through software. A good fan controller will have plenty of headers for all of the fans in your system, as well as an easy way to automate your fan profiles to keep things quiet when your computer is idling, and then ramp them up to an appropriate level when your computer is working hard. It'll also offer a way to monitor temperatures and switch RGB profiles so that you can get your build looking just the way you want, when you want.